it's a pleasure to play with these blokes, and we went out there and we played well today, which is good.
Really enjoyed the 2 weeks with Exiles this year, and we played pretty well today. The weather was good and we were able to throw the ball around, so yeah, really happy, and it was a great experience.
The team's performance today has been a good short preparation, but you know, enjoyable one, and you know, got a good result tonight.
Yeah, I don't know whether I get to keep this one, but no, pleasure to play with the boys. It's some talented guys here, so you know, great concept, happy to do it.
Anyone who thinks rugby league is a young man's sport, think again. At the age of 38, Steve Menzies is still at the top of his game, turning out regularly for the Catalan Dragons in the Super League. And he took on a new challenge this year with the Exiles.
Yeah, they announced I was selected in the 23-man Exile squad to play England next Wednesday. So they announced that after the game. So if you get selected in that, I'll be taken off to England for the week. They started the concept last year to try and bring a state of origin feel fixture, I suppose, to the Super League, and the Exiles are sort of Australian, New Zealand, Islander sort of guys that to play against the England national squad. You know, there's a little bit of rivalry there, obviously coming from Australia. So it's it's only in its early years. They played one game last year, and it's a two-game series this year. But it's only early in its life. So it's just trying to build a little bit of spirit and a bit of passion between the two teams. But I think it's a great concept, something that the Super League definitely needed. I think it's an important part of the year's structure of games.
Eurosport's David Dybman had exclusive access to Menzies and the Exiles team ahead of the England clash. First, the focus on the big Catalan game against Wakefield. Menzies is loving life in the south of France, where he landed at the start of the 2011 season. Here he meets up with two of his Exiles teammates ahead of the game. Menzies is the Super League's oldest player. The man known as the Beaver broke an 8-year-old record set by Castleford's Brad Davis back in 2004.
Let's do it. Here we are at the home ground here. Beautiful sunny weather.
Bon cop, da falls.
Menzies has made a significant contribution to the success of the Catalan club since he headed to the south of France. It's for his exploits at the Manly Sea Eagles that he's best known for.
We've got about an hour and 10 minutes before kickoff. The boys are still pretty relaxed. Having a bit of fruit. The boys are in there getting strapped and massages, and doesn't get too intense for probably another half hour, 20 minutes, then the boys will obviously start to put their boots on, start getting strapped.
Menzies has become a popular player among the French fans. They love his aggressive defence, and he's still scoring plenty of tries. That's when Menzies probably thought there were no new challenges ahead of him. Got a call up to play for the Exiles in their second game of the annual series against England. Exiles coach Daniel Anderson has less than fond memories of his encounters against Menzies down under. He's delighted to have him on his side just this once.
Yeah, we've got Exiles on Wednesday, then we back up again Monday against Warrington, which will be another big test there. They're always very strong, one of the top sides. So it just continues on. I'm sure the temperature will be a little bit less than this, though.
So we should come back more often?
Yeah, you guys might be a good omen. I might have to bring you back every week.
Steve was very close in the first game, Steve Menzies. We had a lot of discussion about him. Very happy to have him on board. He's a lovely character. I've had the opportunity to coach against him for many years in the NRL. Wonderful player. He has punished me a few times as an opposition coach with tries, and I'm hoping that on Wednesday night he delivers some tries for me as a coach for the first time. I've never had the chance to coach him before, And it's a privilege for me because he's a Hall of Famer at the Manly Ringer Club, and I know that Catalan Dragons are also very happy to have had his services over the period they've had him.
This is the second year of the so-called International Origin Series. England won the first game this year in St Helens, 18-10. Menzies came in at second row for the second match in Huddersfield. Great chance for fans to see rugby league stars like Brett Hodgson, Joel Monaghan and Anthony Laffranchi. Menzies is a legend of the game down under. His total of 180 tries is second in the history of Australian first grade rugby league. Anderson delighted to have Menzies in the squad.
Yeah, make sure you can see it, please. Wolf's just coming in. He's just getting off the table. This is for the life and times of Steve Menzies. So just at some stage, everyone will be probably asked to be a part of it. All right. The team will be Hodjo, Joel and Franny on the wings, Joel Moon and Magic, Daryl in the centres. Daniel will be the six. Scotty will be the seven. Front rowers and the starting team, the starting pack and the rotation, I'm still going to have a look at, but at this stage is Harmy and Boof will start. Stranger at nine, and the back row will be Willie, Beaver and Sia, and then the bench will be Con, Lincoln, Sam and Antonio. Okay, they're expecting it to be physical, so we'll set that up. It may be two lead players, it may only be one. I don't want the centre. We'll work it out. Maybe the centre that's on the lead with the second rower to drag that winger in. Okay, that might be the best position. Magic and Joel, you two boys go with the second rower. Bit of footy out the back, two hard lead runners. Franny or Joel sniping a little bit wider. And we drag Briscoe or Charnley in to cover your line. If they don't come in, you can always pass it. Is it going to be a bit more in this one than last game for you boys that are new? We've got a fair few new. We wanted a keep going set last time, but the weather was horrendous and we lost a little bit of support shape in the middle of the field, so we never got to pass the ball from a front row to anyone, so we couldn't get across the field. So we're going to completely change it. The weather's scratchy on the forecast, so I want to set up some short side possibilities. I'll just stay with the halves, please. Give me Hodge, Lincoln, Dan, Scotty, Mick, Stranger. All right. Rest of you boys, you can go and get on the rub table. Optional sessions are on.
Exiles players looked ahead to a unique game and discussed its importance in the development of the sport internationally.
This is a massive game for rugby league in Europe, and hopefully we can build on it and maybe make it a three-game series or something like that. But at the moment, it's going really well, and hopefully the Exiles can retain the trophy.
It's very important to develop the game, get more interest both here in England and back in Australia and New Zealand, the countries that the Exiles represent. So it's a really good concept. Its last game was a good game. They had a great game last year, so hopefully they continue with it, and I think that it can be a very big game in the future.
It's a great concept. I think if all the teams buy into it, and I think it's got some merit, and it'll be around for a long time. It's obviously, you watch the State of Origin back in Australia, and it's the pinnacle of rugby league across the world, and obviously the atmosphere is amazing, and I've been fortunate to play a few times back there, which when you leave Australia you think your rep games are finished, but with this concept it gives the Australian and the New Zealand blokes a chance to play in a rep game against a good team like England.
So that's the view of his new teammates. Indeed, it's a new team for the veteran Menzies, who was put through his paces in a tough training session. Menzies has seen it all in his long career in Australia, where he starred for Manly. Certainly likes life in Perpignan, so much so that he's extended his contract through to the end of 2013, Well, he'll be nearly 40 years old. He's getting used to life with his new Exiles teammates. So how was it to work with fellow greats of the 13-man game?
It's good, obviously, you know, I haven't played with a lot of the guys before, but yeah, some good combinations starting to form out there, and we'll have another run around tomorrow, but it was a good session for us.
Good session indeed, and here's Anderson's take on that first training.
Difficult conditions. It's sprinkly rain and obviously first training, but they're all pros. So the main thing they have to do is talk, because everything else will work. We know their legs and arms and everything else works. Their brains work. They just got to talk to each other, and we'll be okay.
You didn't see a lot of ball going down?
No, they were pretty good, weren't they? You know, and that's the experience in the team. And you know, once again tomorrow, again another session, our last session tomorrow, but we'll ramp it up again tomorrow, and hopefully it's dry. You know, I know it's not going to be sunny, but as long as it's dry, we'll pass the ball.
The Exiles had a full 4 weeks to prepare for the first match. This one, well, they only had 3 days, that after a Sunday, a day when many played a club match. The game itself due for Wednesday.
You know, obviously we come into camp, we had a full week in camp, and I suppose we're probably disrupted by a few injuries, you know, in the Exiles team. But, you know, this time around it's a shorter preparation, but, you know, I think we've got a squad of 21 here at the moment in camp, and, you know, everyone's willing to play, and, you know, we've finalised the squad today, and, you know, it's going to look like a shape up to be a good team.
It's pretty tough. It's, you know, to play for your clubs and then back up for a game of high intensity, like this Exiles England game, it's going to be pretty tough on the bodies. But there are a couple of us that didn't play this weekend, including myself, which is, it's good for me. But it's part of the challenge. When you play a representative game, you've got different experiences to encounter and different ways to prepare for a big game. So it adds to the fact that you are representing, you know, not only your country and your team as well. You've got to then sort of, you know, prepare a little bit different and rise to another level again.
Plenty of preparation, but there was some time for the players to relax. This is an unusual concept. There are players from 6 countries: Australia, the Cook Islands, Tonga, Samoa, Papua New Guinea, and Fiji. It was a precious little time to build up a real team spirit, so Hodgson set up an informal pool tournament. He said that he couldn't resist a bit of coaching, even when it comes to pool. Exiles know they have tough opposition to come from England, and they need a win to retain the trophy.
It's good to get together, a bit of a laugh and a bit of a bonding, especially only got 3 days in camp. So, you know, a lot of most of us have played together before, so, but it's just good to get out of the hotel and do something different.
And you're going to play?
About to play now, straight through the second round. Pretty good too.
Good to have a bit of fun, all the boys together. Last time we had someone's won. We had a bit of a trivia competition last time, and pool night tonight. It's good fun. You know, get to meet someone new in the team that you probably haven't spent much time with as your partner, and you know, give each other a bit of a hard time, and yeah, it's good fun. You're still the same.